He harmed the Americans by letting the immigrants in. In French, they say, number of the key means doesn't matter who. Just let him in, catch and let go, catch and let go. Catch means register and just go. Go anywhere.
Yes, Master.
And then make the pandemic worse because they brought it from every different country.
Correct, yeah.
Those countries who are not very strict with the COVID regulations or vaccines.
Yes.
Those are lesser countries.
Yes.
I just mean in the physical way.
Yeah.
I don't mean there are lesser beings in any way. It's just in a different country has a different status, yeah. Financially or politically or military-wise.
Yes.
So those countries from Latin America, they just came in anybody and then he just let them go anywhere.
Yeah.
One or two or even many of them would have had been sick, would be COVID infected, even if maybe they don't show it.
Yes.
Didn't even test, just catch and let go. Registered and then go, even take them anywhere they want. And make the Americans more susceptible, more vulnerable for pandemic. More people die now, even children die.
Yes, Master.
In Afghanistan, he just let all the troops go, and then whether people over there are rescued or not doesn't matter.
Yes.
Until international pressure and internal pressure, then he rushed more airplanes to take them out. Still too late.
Yes.
Don't know how many are still trapped in there.
Yes, Master.
The evacuation's not over, Mr. Right. President. There's still Americans stuck, SIV holders, green card holders, that right now, as we speak, veterans groups are still trying to help get out. They're trapped at airports, in the vicinity of airports around Afghanistan. You know why? Because the State Department won't give the proper clearances for these private chartered flights to get out. And in the few instances where they have, then the Taliban won't let them go. You know what that's called? That's called a hostage.
Right.
And we are heading into a mass hostage situation where the Taliban has all the leverage to get international legitimacy, access to billions in foreign currency, and economic assistance. And we handed them that legitimacy on a silver platter in the form of hundreds of Americans that Joe Biden left behind.
Maybe the Taliban won't do anything to them because of fear of diplomatic problems.
Praise them.
But still, the pressure for them over there,
yeah.
When everybody else is gone and they just left behind like that.
Yes, unfair.
Yeah, they feel very, very scared, very fearful. The psychological pressure on them is enormous.
A pregnant U.S. citizen trying to escape with her husband and her father. She claims the Taliban is blocking her and even kicked her in the stomach.
She's going to stay sheltered in place, hiding her identity, and hoping that her friends will continue to bring her food and keep her secret until frankly, we can come up with something new. We know her exact location, but literally are afraid to even have a conversation about a rendezvous until we know where and when somebody could meet her. Anyone who wants to remain, unknown has to switch phones, turn them off, use all the techniques that you would use if you were in survival, escape, and evasion. We also have an elderly couple, the same thing, repeatedly went to the gate waited at the gate with their blue passports and did not get in. So anyone that says that they didn't break a promise to the American people and leave people behind is wrong. Anyone who says that there aren't people stranded is wrong. These people were stranded. They did everything they were supposed to do, and they simply were not a priority at the end.
And people die at the Kabul airport and die also more elsewhere because of the drone strike. So this is a very clear evidence that Mr. Biden will harm the Americans and other countries' citizens, also the international peace.
Yeah.
And how many more disasters can Mr. Biden afford? Can the Americans afford to let him?
Right.
And this guy, McConnell, trying to play this game of good guy again. He can't afford this.
No.
He's supporting somebody who harms his co-citizens.
Yes.
That's no good. He should retire. Or people should fight him also.
Yes, Master.
Anybody who did this kind of misjudgment is not a mistake.
Yes.
Either deliberate or too stupid.
Right.
Or too much for the consolidation of his own position and power, that he couldn't care less who dies, who lives. He's not fit to be in a position in the government anywhere.
No,
he's not just being a leader, but being anywhere in the government, especially at the top, in the center of the government,
right,
in the capital, as the Senate or as the House of Representatives. This kind of person is very harmful for the country. He gets paid to help, to protect, to promote the wellness of his country. And he did the opposite.
Yes.
Yeah. The border problem, he also did not do much. And now many Americans die, obviously, in front of him. He still does nothing. He does nothing. He still supports this kind of action to harm more Americans.
Right, yeah.
That's why this guy is no good.
I agree.
Does he realize what he's doing? Or he's just blindly trying so hard to protect his power, his grip on his colleague?
Yes.
And who never worked with him to show people that he's a tough guy, that he knows everything, and he can decide things? To impeach Biden or not impeach Biden, it doesn't lie in his hands alone.
Yes.
If the Senate and the House of Representatives realize the seriousness of Mr. Biden's handling of everything. If they realize it, they couldn't care less whether or not McConnell say what.
Yes, Master.
But it's not for him to stand up and say, no, Biden cannot be impeached. It won't happen.
Mm.
Can he foresee the future, perhaps? Like a clairvoyant or something?
Mm.
Or is he so sure of his power grip on everybody that he can announce like that?
No.
It's too arrogant.
True.
The government leader, the leaders of any type in the nation, cannot be arrogant.
Yes, Master.
Because you will fall. You will harm people if you're too arrogant, because you're too far from reality.
Yes.
I don't know if I am clear enough of you. You understand everything or not?
Yes, I understand, really. It's really not fair to the American people to...
It's not just not fair, it's harmful.
Yes, it is truly harmful.
Not fair is too much.
Yes.
He cannot afford to continue this way and supporting Biden so that he can make more trouble, can do more harm to the Americans and others, related others, like maybe other international citizens, because of that. Because continuing like this, it might make more war.
Yes, Master.
And many people will die because the international troops will also have to support Americans.
Yes.
Yeah, they always did, because it's a pact, it's an alliance, and NATO and all that, bringing many more people to die with.
Yes, understand.
So this is not a mistake. It's a taboo. I don't know how you say this. Either very stupid or very arrogant that he doesn't even realize the reality, or is far removed from reality, or just too power greedy that he couldn't care less who dies, who lives.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying?
Yes.
Yeah, it's become a habit for him now, just to say things big like that. just to exercise the grip on anybody, so that everybody has to listen to him and feel like he's a wise person. He's not.
Yes.
Can you see he's not?
Yes.
Either that, or he's just too power blind that he would do anything just to consolidate his position.
Right.
Yeah, at the cost of other people's lives. He should be removed together with Biden.
They should be removed, yes. And soon.
It's not because of Republican or Democrat or anything. But he just betrays anybody and then befriends anybody just so that everybody feels like they own it to him. You see? Mm. Like their life depends on his judgment.
Mm, yeah.
So he can criticize or condemn them whenever he wants. And then when that person is already down on his knees and he comes, extending his hands, and that person will forever be indebted to him.
Oh, gosh.
You see that?
Yeah.
That's a very wicked strategy. Normal situation, no, not serious. Okay, but this is people's lives that he's playing with. And I condemn that. Everybody should.
Yes, Master.
Should remove him immediately before he makes more trouble and causes more pain and suffering to the American people who pay him through taxes.
Yes, Master, yes.
He should be more loyal and protective toward them, his employers, the ones who pay him.
Yeah, absolutely.
The Americans are the ones who pay him. They are his employers. He should be more protective toward them, not to any individual, just so that he can control all the powers.
Yes.
Control people mentally and psychologically.
Yes, Master.
Whew, I don't know how to express this more eloquently. I'm just telling you as it comes out, okay?
Yes, Master, I understand.
I said just straight from my heart and the way I see it.
It is very clear and straightforward, yes, Master.
It's clear, yeah?
Yes.
Good.
It is.
Any questions about that? Any doubts I can explain to you? Like if you're not clear anywhere?
Is there anyone who actually can remove Mr. McConnell? I wonder if actually someone can act on it.
Yeah, I think they can if they want to. If he's not doing a good job.
Yes.
Anybody can remove him. They should.
They should.
It depends on the Constitution.
Right.
But he is clearly like betraying his country and his people.
Right, yes.
If that's as strong as possible that I can use the word for you, okay? Mm-hmm. Even though it doesn't look like it. Looks like he always says something just so that he can be in the position of, maybe you call it like a hero or something. Good guy.
Yeah.
Trump and then now Biden and Cheney and whoever. If other people will contradict, he would come and defend for that person. Even if the House or the Senate don't want that person, he will come up and defend for that person. Yeah, so that person will forever be indebted to him. Yeah. Even if that person loses or wins, he always counts him as a friend. So he can beat a person, he can praise a person, he can drag the person down and he can lift him up. He does all that.
It's vicious.
Yeah, imagine. Just to look powerful. People will be confused, don't know anything, and thinking he's just a very fair person. Mm. No, he's playing.
Oh, wow.
He's playing games, mind games, psychological games, at the cost of other people's lives, especially his own constituents, his own compatriots.
Understand.